हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट, वेलकम टू नागेशकर रसगे ऑर्किड स्कूल चैनल। मायसेल्फ हिना पटेल, गोइंग टू टीच यू 7th स्टैंडर्ड मैथमेटिक्स। ऑलरेडी इन द प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैड लर्न अबाउट द सिंपल इक्वेशंस, हाउ टू सब्स्टिट्यूट द वैल्यूज ऑफ अ वेरिएबल। व्हाट आर वेरिएबल? एडिशन ऑफ अ 3 और सब्ट्रैक्शन ऑफ अ 3 टू द बोथ द साइड्स। So in different way we had studied equations. Today we will see some more example related to the equation. So here first we have to separate the variable and we have to try to solve the equations. Here some examples are given. First step is to solve the or separate the variable. So here it is 3L is equal to 42. What is 3L? 3L is nothing but 3 multiplied by L is equal to 42. What is the variable here is L. So, to find out L separately, first what we have to do? We have to, if it is a multiplication, we have to divide. So, 3L divided by 3 is equal to 42 divided by 3. Dividing both the side by 3. So, 3 get cancelled. 3 get cancelled here. So, L will be left. That is, a variable is left. And if it is possible to reduce, we can reduce here is 3 1s are 3, 14, 3, 4s are. So here will be L is equal to, here will be 7, 3 7s are 42 and here 3 multiplied by L is equal to 14. So another example we will see is B upon 2 is equal to 6. Here we have B in the numerator, so we have to multiply to the numerator, so 2 get cancelled and we get as a b. So 2 get cancelled, we are multiplying 2 on the both the side, so here it will get cancelled and b is equal to 6, 2s are 12. So in this way we can find, substitute the, first we have to find out the variable separately, then we have to do the steps. One more example we will see, so you will understand what is the steps to be followed when it is given. Here we are having both the things in the fraction form. Z upon 3 is equal to 5 upon 4. What is Z upon 3? We have to, when it is 3, we have to get Z separately, that is a variable. We have to multiply this Z by 3. Multiplying 3 on the both the side. We have to write every time to the right hand side of a textbook, sorry, notebook, multiplying both the side by 3 or multiply 3 on the both the side, both statements are same. So Z upon 3 multiplied by 3 is equal to 5 upon 4 multiplied by 3. Just we had multiplied 3 on the both the side, keeping both the fractions as it is. Here if it is possible reduced, we will reduce here 3 1s are 3 1s are, so it will be Z. Now we have to multiply both the numerator, because in the previous chapter we had learned both the numerators we have to multiply. So it is 5, 3s are 15 and this is 4. So 15 upon 4, what is the value of a Z? That is a variable we had separated and we got the value of a Z is 15 upon 4. So these are the example. Another example, A upon 5 is equal to 7 upon 15. A upon 5 as it is, to get A separately we have to multiply what we are having, a number in the denominator, same number we have to multiply in the numerator. So by multiplying both the side by 5, so we are multiplying here 5 as well as here 5. Reduce this 5 or cancel this 5 and write A is equal to 5. Here also we have to reduce 5 1s are, 5 3s are, so it will be 7 upon 3. These are the example how first we have to separate the variable by multiplying the given form of a fraction, and we have to step by step we have to find out the value of variable. Some more examples we will see here. Give first the step you will use to separate the variable. It may be variable, you know now what variables are the different, that is N, A, P, L, X. These are the different variables which are used in the algebra for the equations as well as expressions. And solve the equations. we have to solve the equation step by step. Here in the previous questions we had seen just we have to multiply and find out the variable separately, but here we are having all the sums are of a different. So sometime we have to add, sometime we have to multiply, sometime we have to divide, or sometime we have to subtract. So how we have to use this all the operations here to find a variable? Here in the first example is n. So 3n minus 2 is equal to 46. First we have to write the separate the first 3n. Here we are having minus 2, so what we will do is plus 2, because we want to separate 3n. We can't separate directly a variable because variable is always with number here in this question. So it is 3n. So adding a 2 on both the side, here also we are adding 2, 46 also, that is RHS we are adding 2. Adding 2 on both the side, this minus 2 and plus 2 get cancelled. Now we got is 3n, and you know the simple addition, 46 plus 2 is equal to 48. Then what will be the second step? We have to write a 3, we want only n. So what to do? Here we are having multiplication, so we have to divide by 3. So dividing both the side by 3. So now n will be separated, yes, and here we will reduce it. That will be 3 ones are 3, 16s are 48. So n is equal to 16. Here 3 get cancelled, so n is left, that is variable. What we are doing? We are doing a two operations in solving this equation step by step. First we have to find us or separate the variable, then we have to solve the equation. So we will see one more example so you will understand how to do this. Here we are having in the second example 5m plus 7 is equal to 17. It's very simple, yes. This first we are having a variable with a number, so we have to separate it. Here we are having addition, so to get a variable separate we have to subtract 7 on the both the side. Here 5m plus 7 minus 7 is equal to 17 minus 7. What we are doing? Subtracting 7 off on both the sides. So here minus 7, here minus 7. Now it is 5m is equal to, after subtracting 17 minus 7 is 10. So 5m is equal to 10. Now we have to separate this m, which we are having here multiplication, so we have to go for division here. So 5m upon 5 is equal to 10 upon 5, because dividing both the side by 5, so we want a variable separate. So now 5 get cancelled, so it will be now m is equal to 5 ones are 5, 5 twos are 10, so is equal to 2. So m is equal to 2. Here we had done two different types of operations. Here is subtracting and one is dividing. Here we will see another example, 20p upon 3 is equal to 40. We have to separate first 20p, yes. So what we have to do? Here we are having in the 3 in the division, so we have to multiply 3, so this 20p will get separated. So multiplying 3 on both the side, or multiplying both the side by 3. So we are multiplying 3 here, 3 here. So these 3 get cancelled, because it is in the numerator, this is in the denominator. 3 get cancelled. Now it is 20p. It will be 20p is equal to, writing is equal to 40 multiplied by 3, means you know magic of 0, write 1 0 and multiply the number, 4 3s are 12. So now what equation we got is 20p is equal to 120. That day also I told it is a sign of implies. This we can't write equal to, because here is already LHS is equal to RHS. So 20p is equal to 120. Now we want a variable p separate. Here we are having multiplication, so we will divide 20 by 20 on both the side, dividing both the side by 20. So what will be 20 get cancelled, 20 get cancelled, what it is, p. P is equal to this 0 get cancelled, 2 1s are 2 6 are, so p is equal to 6. While looking, it may be thinking how to solve, but step by step you have to find out a variable and number. Then in the second step you can find out only the variable separately by solving the steps. Fourth example we will see, 3p upon 10 is equal to 6. So first what we will do, we will have a separate 3p. To get 3p separate, we have to multiply it by 10, because this we are, it is given in the denominator as 10, or it is divided by 10. So this 10 get cancelled and we get as a 3p. We have to multiply on both the side because we have to balance the equation. So 6 multiplied by 10, this is to the right hand side, and we are multiplying 10 to the left hand side. So this both get cancelled. So it will be 3p. Here direct multiplication, 10 6 or 6 times 10 is 60. So 3p is equal to 60. Now afterward, what we have to do here, we have to separate the variable as a p. So what will be 3p upon 3, because here it is multiplication, we have to divide by 3 on the both the side. So 3 3 get cancelled, this 3 and this 3 get cancelled, so it will be remain only p. And here 60 upon 3, we have to reduce it, 3 1s are 3, 2s are 6 and 0 as it is, so it is 20. So p is equal to 20. In this way, first we have to find out a variable with a number. In the second step, we can find out separately the variable by dividing on the both the side, or multiplying on the both the side, or by adding or subtracting on the both the side. These are the things, sums what we had learned here. You can prepare your own variable with your own number, and you can try to find out what will be the value of variable and how to check the example that what value you have find out is correct or not. So first what you will do, you when you are getting the value of variable, that value you have to substitute in a equation which is given in the form of a question, which is given in the question. So what is 20, p is equal to 20, if you put right as a value of p is equal to 20, so 23 multiplied by 20 is equal to 6. How you will get it, because it is possible to reduce here, so you will get both the side will be equal to each other. So we can say that LHS is equal to RHS. Now we will see some more examples regarding the equations. Solve the following equations. Here they had not told us to find out a variable first step which to be used. Here it is only equations are given, just we have to see step by step how we can solve the equations and find out the values of variable. Here is 10p is equal to 100. If it is given in the form of a filling the blanks, you can do very smart work. No need to do this all the steps. If it is in the MCQ, you can reduce here only. I will give that trick also. So you can do here, it is 10p is equal to 100 is nothing but is 100 is in denominator. If you have cancel 10 from the left hand side, you have to cancel 10 from right hand side. So if you cancel here 0, if you cancel here 0, what will be the left? 10 get cancelled, here the p is equal to 10. So value of p is equal to 10. So we will see step by step, 10p is equal to 100. So here is multiplication, so we have to do the division, divide 10 on both the side, or dividing both the side by 10, both are same. Here I am dividing it by 10 on both sides, so this 10 get cancelled, this 10 get cancelled, here this 1 0 get cancelled, this 1 0 get cancelled. So P is equal to 10. Another example, 10P plus 10 is equal to 100. Here we have to first find out, first separate the 10P, because in the previous question also we had seen the variable with a number, first we have to separate it. To separate this 10P, we are having here plus 10, so what should be done? Minus 10. Minus 10 is equal to 100 minus 10, subtracting both the side by 10. Now what will be, this 10 get cancelled, both the 10 get cancelled, so what will be left? 10P is equal to, you know, 100 minus 10, 90. Now 10P is equal to 90. This is not completed because we have to find out a value of P. So what will write? P is equal to, what will be that? Here is 10P, so what we have to do? Divide 10 on both the side. So what we have to do? Divide 10 on both the side, dividing both side by 10. So 10P is divided by 10 and 90 is also divided by 10. So 10P upon 10 means this, both the 10 get cancelled, and P is equal to, this 0 get cancelled, so what will be left is 9. So P is equal to 9. In this way, step by step, first you have to find out the value of a variable with a number, and then by separating again a variable and find out the value of a variable. Now one more example we will see here. P upon 4 is equal to 5. P upon 4 is equal to 5. So here we are having a 4 in the denominator. So same number, what we have to do? We will multiply it, so this both 4 get cancelled. So we will get as a value, as a variable, as a P. So multiplying 4 on both the side. So we are multiplying 4 on the LHS and 4 on the RHS. This both get cancelled. So P is equal to 5 4s are 20. So it is very easy because here it is directly given as a separate variable without any a number. Now next we are having in some of negative integers. So here it is minus P upon 3 is equal to 5. Just you have to consider this negative sign, because the value, if you don't consider, the value will change. So P upon minus P upon 3 is equal to 5. So to get a separate P, we have to multiply it minus 3. Why we are multiplying with minus 3? I told, just again recall your integers, that minus into minus is plus. So minus P multiplied by minus 3 is minus 3P, or plus 3P here, but we can cancel here or cut here as 3 ones are, minus into minus is plus, so we get as a P. So have you understood why we are multiplying with minus 3 on both the side? Because we want a P as a variable separate. So multiplying minus into minus, that will be plus, so we get as a plus P is equal to, we are multiplying on the both the side, so you know now 5 3s are 15 and it is a minus, so we have to write minus 15, or we can say it is a negative integer, so it is in minus 15. So P is equal to minus 15. In this way we have to see when it is a subtraction sign, so we have to be very careful while multiplying the number. Another example, 3p upon 4 is equal to 6. 3p upon 4 is equal to 6. We have to find out first 3p separately. We can't find out p separately here because it's with a number. First, what we'll do? We will find out 3p separately. How to find out? Because here we are having a divided by 4 or upon 4, so we will multiply it by 4 so it can be reduced. So multiplying 4 on both this side. So we are multiplying to the LHS as well as to the RHS. So 3p upon 4 multiplied by 4 is equal to 6 multiplied by 4. So 4, 4 get cancelled. So it will be now 3p. 3p is equal to how much? 6, 4 is 24. So 3p, what we are going to do for 3p? Because we want a p variable separate, we will divide it by 3. So dividing 3 on both the side, so what we write? 3p upon 3 is equal to 24 upon 3. Here 3, 3 get cancelled. So what will be here? P. So P is equal to 3 ones are 3, 8s are 24. So P is equal to 8. In this way, we had find out the value of P by using two operations. One is multiplication and one is division. Where we are having a variable with a number, so it required two steps or two operations to find out the value of a variable. One more examples we are having here with some different variables, because already I told the values of variables differs with numbers. So here is 3s is equal to minus 9. What is 3s? 3 multiplied by s. So it is multiplication, so we have to go for a division to get a separate s. Here we don't have a capital S, it is a small s, so you have to write a small s. In the previous question also it was a small. Already in the starting of a chapter I told that always we have to use a small alphabets as a variable. So 3s upon 3 is equal to minus 9 divided by 3, dividing both the side by 3. We are dividing by 3 to get a variable s separate. So 3 get cancelled in the numerator and the denominator, and s is equal to 3 ones are and 3 threes are 9. So we will have 3, but it is a minus, so we have to write a minus 3. Don't forget to carry the sign with the number. So here we are getting s is equal to minus 3. So in this way we had find out the value of s as a variable. Another example, 3s plus 12 is equal to 0. 3s plus 12 is equal to 0. So to get 3s separate, what should be done with this? Plus 12, we have to go for minus 12. Subtracting both side by 12. Here it is printing mistake. So it is subtracting both side by 12. So here we are subtracting plus 12 minus 12 is equal to 0 minus 12. So this minus 12 and plus 12 both get cancelled. So it will be 3s is equal to minus 12. Now we have to separate s. So what we have to do? Here we are having multiplication, so we have to divide it by 3. So dividing 3 on both this side, that is 3s upon 3 is equal to minus 12 upon 3. Here 3, 3 get cancelled. It is s is equal to 3 ones are 3 fours are. So it will be 4, but we have here minus, so we have to carry a minus sign. So s is equal to minus 4. In this way we can find out the value of any variable which are denoted by different alphabets. Another example, 3s is equal to 0. 3s is equal to 0. So to find out or to separate the s, what we have to do? First we will divide it by 3 on the both the side. So 3s divided by 3 is equal to 0 divided by 3. This both get cancelled. S will be left. S is equal to, we can't write 0 upon 3. We say it's a 0. So in this way S is equal to 0. So we have done many examples. Some more example we will see. So your concept where we are you are finding a difficulties that will be solved. Here we are having 2q is equal to 6. 2q is equal to 6. It's a q because it's not a 9. It is not written at the top. It is in the down in the small alphabet. So it is 2q is equal to 6. To get a q separate, we have to divide it by 2. So 2q upon 2 is equal to 6 upon 2. That is nothing but upon 2 is nothing but it is a division. So here 2 get cancelled from the numerator and the denominator, and q will be the separated here. If reduce it here to 1s and 2 3s, so will be q is equal to 3. With a one operation only we had find out the values here. Here 2q minus 6 is equal to 0. 2q minus 6 is equal to 0. So first we have to find out separately a 2q, because we are having a variable with a 2. We can't separate as q directly. So step by step we will go. We will separate 2q. We are having minus 6. To cancel this minus 6, we have to add 6. So here we are adding a 6 on the both the side. So when you write to the LHS, that is left hand side plus 6 and right hand side plus 6, in this way we will get here minus 6 and plus 6 both get cancelled. You will have as a 2q is equal to 0 plus 6 is 6. So 2q is equal to 6. So 2q upon 2 is equal to 6 upon 2. Here 2 get cancelled. It is a q is equal to 3. So in this way we had find out with here two operations, additions as well as division, and we had find out the value of q is equal to 3. Here 2q plus 6 is equal to 0. To find out 2q separately, to remove 2q separately, first what we have to do? We have to subtract 6 from the given that plus 6. So this will be 0. So here 2q plus 6 minus 6, subtracting both the side by 6. So minus 6, 0 minus 6. Here 2q, this both the plus and minus get cancelled. So 2q is equal to minus 6. 2q is equal to minus 6. 2q is equal to minus 6. To find out this variable separate, so what we have to do? We have to divide it by 2. So getting this dividing by 2 to the LHS as well as RHS on the both the side, these 2 get cancelled and we write q is equal to 2 1s are 2 3s are 6. So q is equal to minus 3. In this way we had find out the value of q by subtracting and by dividing on both the side. Because it's an equation, we have to do on both the side. Here 2q plus 6 is equal to 12. Here again plus 6, so we have to go for minus 6 to get its 0. So we can find out as a 2q, subtracting 6 on both the side. So this 6 plus 6 minus 6 get cancelled. It will be 2q is equal to 12 minus 6 is 6. So dividing 2 to get Q separate. So Q is equal to, these 2 get cancelled. So Q is equal to, we can reduce here, 2 1s are 2, 3s are 6. So Q is equal to 3. In this way we had find out the value of Q as 3. Today we had seen many different types of example how to find out a value of variable as well as we had solved the equations which is given with different variables. Please practice from the textbook. Thank you very much.